NCTV45, The Train, anytime on your time.
What's the date? Happy 25th. Two mics.
Live from downtown Newcastle. It's the J&J, or the Padula Show featuring J&J. Yeah, it's Padula Monday, show, the 25th.
Yeah. Unbelievable. You know what?
Good to see ya. Thelma, Louise, Midge, no, Marge.
Yeah,
Matt.
Midge and Marge. Listen, you know what kills me? I'm so upset.
What? You're mixed up.
No, I'm not mixed up. Can we get an episode right? One episode.
No. Every episode this week was perfect.
Except you couldn't hear the music.
Yeah, where? In Kenya. The sound was off. Then you said there was an echo. Poor Mr. Weatherby, you know, from what I understand.
If you noticed, that was when I wasn't here.
He brings up a good point.
Was he here?
He wasn't there for Newswatch, but the last week's episodes, folks, we apologize again. Not so much that I don't feel bad, because finally you couldn't hear him, and which is better, and you couldn't hear the crap music he was playing. So
that's not. But how does that happen?
I don't know.
We are the number one
production
show. Right. And so who's in charge of that?
No, it's.
Huh? What?
You know.
I'm upset because. These fine people that made us number one, okay? Now I sound like Donald Trump, that made us number one, right?
Right.
Because we're number one in the ratings, CNN, Fox, all right, MSNBC.
Right. Well, you won't be able to hear this. Either that or so loud that you won't be able to hear us.
Yeah.
One or the other. Well, it's like what the Germans used to do in World War II, where they'd send somebody in an American uniform, army uniform, and send them behind enemy lines, and what did they do?
Animal lines.
Yep.
They took animals behind the lines? So that would leave trouble, wouldn't they? It'd be easy to find them, right? No, I mean, what you said. No, wouldn't it be?
The Germans would send one of their troops behind enemy lines.
There's a big difference there.
And they would dress in American soldiers' uniforms, and they would... What's the word I'm looking for?
They would.
Yeah. Oh, you are absolutely useless.
Camouflage. What? I'm the one that should be mad.
Starts with an S.
Excuse
I can't remember.
Me,
sabotage.
Sabotage.
Guys.
Yeah.
What?
I know.
They can't hear you.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, they're
you
hearing
have to speak
me.
Up.
Do you have the mic on?
People wanted you
People
to know
Bryson?
That.
What?
This is the new theme song for Cloakin' and Castle.
Not a crappy song for
a
crappy show.
Crappy song. Yeah.
Good.
We're still the one.
Wonderful. Still the one, wouldn't it be?
Still the one.
We're still number one.
Right, right. You'd be look. He should have had this stuff done.
Busted! Busted! Folks, obviously you couldn't see that. He failed. You probably couldn't hear him at all because he failed to turn on his mics yet once again.
Cooking the Castle is...
Still the one. Yeah.
Cooking the Castle is still the one.
Let's see. Still the one. It's an adjective.
Right.
Like, they send people out to show you. They send people out to capture me, to bring me back.
Doesn't make
bring you back. You know what? I'm not changing the subject, but we will have a news story this week about, you know, El Chapo
was captured. Right.
And he's very upset. I mean, I can't believe this guy. I guess when they brought him to prison, he was very depressed, which wouldn't be a good thing.
He escaped again.
No, he did not. Oh,
His brother,
El Cuco.
Right.
I think they saw that. Some of your viewers, or a lot of your viewers, saw that this week. Mm-hmm. Well, I guess you got rights.
I'll have an exclusive interview
with El Cuco
later this week.
Wow. That's going to be
exciting.
I'm not
sure which day it is because, you know, his schedule is in flux because he's in hiding.
Right, right.
Much like Sean Penn, I feel very much like Sean Penn, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
But I have convinced...
I understand that before he was captured...
Freaking halt.
Now what? They're not going to hear anything you do. Now what are you playing? Let me hear.
Joel, please say what you want to say.
So what are you playing now?
Well, see, that's the thing. Like, I have ADD, so the minute you cut me off, I completely lose train of thought. And all the drugs I did in my late teens and early 20s has fried my brain. So when I'm on a track, I got to keep that train moving.
Stay that train.
Train.
On time, anytime. Your time. NCTV 45.
Here.
Go ahead. It's
right
there.
There's only one thing to do then.
What?
Do the Lido shuffle.
How can they get in touch with this? How can they get in touch with this?
Yep.
724-600.
724-600.
What is it? Garfield 1? 28. What is it?
That is
priceless. We have done over 200 episodes.
200 episodes.
And we've said the phone number maybe two, three
what
times
is it?
An episode.
724.
I told you. I made
what
this,
is it?
I made this very
Alexa,
specific. Did
help
I
me
not?
Out.
Alexa. Did I not last week make it very specific? When he uses the term, get in touch,
right.
I'm done.
All right, all right.
I'm done.
You're going
to
have to
get him
decaf. Here's how you can contact us.
You're going to have to get him decaf. He's a little high strung.
He is.
Because you know what? This is what I was told. I was told via Twitter that last week I didn't seem interested, and I was kind of just playing around over here, really wasn't paying attention. So from the outset, Monday morning, all week, I am engaged.
Good.
I'm locked and loaded, baby. Like El Chapo's 50 cal, baby. 50 cal.
You understand that you were being compared to
Cook. They gave him the book, Don Quixote.
You were being compared to Cook in a castle, and so you're when you're number two, you try harder.
No, we're not number two.
You could say a lie over and over and over again. It's not becoming fact.
You are the Carly Fiorina of the ratings here on NCTV 45.
You are the Tennille to our captain.
Right. Oh. And you are the Matt to our Geiger. Because is he still on the air?
You are the Fighting Irish to our Buckeyes.
That's right. I mean, there's no comparison.
He loved that.
There's no comparison.
Well, I'll just have to get Geiger to kick a field goal.
Where is he? Where is that guy?
El Chapo.
Where's he been?
50 cows.
He's in undercover.
Really? You did? You know what they do to him, which is, I find it very fascinating. What, Alexa, honey?
He's our El Chapo.
We're not going to probably hear her, right?
Well, no, you can't.
We
There's
can't hear her. Sorry.
Nothing could be done.
Like
she
dad.
Said he's the El to our Chapo.
He's, yeah.
Well,
Shemp.
They move him.
Who?
Randomly.
Who?
What?
Chapo.
El.
Canito.
Kanishiwa. El. Chapo.
M-N-O-P.
No, El Canelo's. No, El Chapo.
Right.
They, no, his last name is not right. It's El Chapo Guzman. They move him at randomly.
Speaking of El Chapo.
Unbeknownst to him.
For your lawyer needs.
Oh.
Daimyo and Olsen is only one phone call away.
And they're using Chinese to help move him. They go, move, chop, chop.
So.
You can send. Your anger text to 724-510-7349.
Crazy week.
That number again, 724-510. Listen.
Go ahead.
734-4-5.
You know how many people liked the duck?
Nobody.
No, get out.
Everybody.
All the teachers. I'm sorry, the teachers out there.
Newcastle.
That's everybody.
That's everybody.
Yeah.
I talked to three people that thought it was funny.
Speaking of Newcastle, let me just
got any grapes?
It's Monday. Let me just say this. They're ranked number one in the WPIL.
Who?
Right. And the Red Hurricanes, Newcastle. They're undefeated. Ranked number one in the WPIL. They are ranked number four in the state. But the other day, my son and I...
53 in the country, if I'm not mistaken.
Right. And so we figured out...
Good. I'm glad you figured that out.
We figured out
very clear.
The head coach...
Oh, there's going after Weller. El Chapo.
Yeah.
Weller. Oh, Weller.
Mr.
That's
Weller.
Right. He's in the ambulance.
We figured
he
out...
He was sick,
Blunder's
but he got Weller.
Blunder's... Blunder. Who?
He was sick and he got Weller.
Weller. Wow. We tried to figure out Blundo's record. And I think he's won, at this point, 200 games. And if we calculated it correctly, and maybe, Mr. Blundo, if you're, I know you watch the show, even though sometimes you go on as a guest on WKST, Ken LaBovey, who now has to work on Saturdays to compete with NCTV45.
Did you notice that?
Yeah, I noticed that. He has to get up. He's so angry.
He's never done Saturdays ever in his entire career. No. But now all of a sudden, he decided. The way he said it, though, is I want to expand my audience.
No,
in other words, he wants to try to get some of his audience back, which are you folks that are watching something that's entertaining.
And here's you know what?
Fact.
On that note, okay?
Is that an F or a G?
Well,
C?
On
C
that
sharp?
Note,
B flat.
Let me throw this by you. All right?
Ready.
He was talking about the Red Hurricanes playing hoops and how you can get to that sports channel. What's that sports channel, two mics? Thank you.
MSA Sports.
Yeah. But you can't see it, but you can hear it.
You can
Whereas
hear it.
Whereas if he would be nice and say, hey, but if you actually want to see and hear the game, NCTV 45. Okay? So that's why they're doing that. And
Lebovey, you're on your way, buddy. One day.
What?
One day.
What do you mean?
You will be the Spartans to our Buckeyes. One day.
The Spartans.
You might knock off Cook in the Castle. Maybe. Just keep trying.
Yeah. Well, I just...
I hear Sundays after church is a wonderful time slot.
You're right. How do you know that?
Because I know his audience. I know his audience very well.
Well, you know what they've been doing lately? Because, you know, I got to be quite honest with you.
People that watch Lebovey?
They don't watch him. But what I do a lot of research and I listen to, whether it be KBN, whether it be KDKA, 1020.
That's my relative.
It is relative. What do you mean?
That's my relative. Well, Weatherby. Who? Whether it be.
Weatherby. Right. Mr. Weatherby. He's got a big birthday, too. You know, Well, we'll talk about that this week.
We'll talk about that.
But anyway, ladies and gentlemen, what I'm
big news on the Weatherby front. Mr. Weatherby has become, speaking of number one, has become number one in a very distinctive and specific way.
We'll tell you about that this week. But getting back to what I was talking about, and now I don't even care what I was talking about because I don't care. But I do know one thing.
Whether it be...
Weatherby reminds me of my old aunt and uncle.
Mm-hmm.
They
just the ones that went to the therapist?
With the sex and everything. Okay. Well, they had another story.
Okay.
Can I tell it real quick? It's Monday.
Sure.
Okay, Madge, you got it, Midge. Madge, sit down. Make sure you're already... Okay, you got it? Get some napkins, because this you may find is entertaining, may find it funny.
You might cough you out the nose.
So here, they went to a bar. Now, don't forget, they're in their 80s. So my aunt and uncle, you know... They went to a bar. They're sitting in a bar, and my aunt goes to my uncle. She goes, look, remember we were here 50 years ago, and we were talking like this, and we went outside, and we went up against the fence, and I held the fence. Yeah, and we had sex up against the fence.
Oh, that's not what I was. I thought they were singing karaoke.
And she goes, wow, that'd be something great to do. Well, what they didn't know was a police officer was listening. To their conversation.
Listening.
Yeah, okay. To their conversation.
Okay.
So here he was like...
Get on the dash cam?
Very, very curious because he said, oh, my God, it's been over 50 years. I've been married for 15 years. I'm going to...
Telephone.
I'm going to... Maybe that's them. That's my aunt and uncle.
They might be pretty upset.
So here.
Mr. Weatherby, tell him it's next couple days from now.
Next couple days. So here... They actually, she says, come on, let's go do this. Let's go outside. We haven't done this in all these years, 50 years.
And her handprints are still on the fence.
No. So they said, no problem. Well, here, the police officer, he wanted to see what the heck was going on. He said, I have to see this. I have to see the passion in these two people. They go outside. Same thing. She goes up. She holds on to the fence.
Mm-hmm.
And he does his thing. Boom. He couldn't believe what he saw for 10, 15 minutes, the shaking, the hair going up and down. They were going crazy, and then all of a sudden it was over. So here, at first he said, maybe I should go over and say something to him, and he said, nah, I better not. But then he really thought about it. He says, excuse me, he goes, look. And here they are, she's pulling her panties up, and he's pulling his pants up. Mm-hmm. He goes, look, I couldn't help overhearing you in the bar.
Mm-hmm.
About it's been over 50 years, the fence, you had to bring back those good memories. He goes, look, I've been married for a few years. I just want to make sure I have that passion. He goes, I just couldn't believe what went on for 15 minutes, that fire.
Mm-hmm.
She goes, well, now the fence is electric. So that's it. So yeah. That's.
You know what was great about that story? It was very short and concise.
Yeah. It was electric. No, she was holding on. And the fence was electric. And back in the day, it wasn't. Well, it's just a little story to get them. I didn't say it was a joke or anything. Well, like that.
Midge thought it was
pretty
funny.
Well, she thought it was funny because she goes to the same place. Okay? So she just likes to hold on to the fence. That's it. Without anybody coming
around. And she likes to sit on the washing machine too, right?
Well, yes. Because maybe the Maytag repairman comes in. Okay? Now we got a laugh track on. Is he working on something else?
Yeah,
again?
Probably.
He's probably doing another
Now we
episode.
Finally have a couple of interns and people that are doing some production for us,
right.
Post-production for us.
You would think he'd be on the show.
You'd think he'd be like, like right on it, but no. Well, you know why? He's pouting.
Again?
Yeah.
Why? Because he's number 12?
Yeah,
he's right behind Geiger.
I could tell. He's pouting.
He's going to be dropping out of the race like Rick Perry.
Did you read our signs? I mean,
look.
Come on, man.
Angelo is funny. We're pushing you.
We're
promoting you. Look.
Wave offer from you on that one. Now, I
don't know. He's playing something in the background. It sounds like Three Stooges.
And listen, the... getting back to Blundo, did I tell you about
it? We never got into Blundo.
Yeah, I said he's won at least 200 games.
Instead of saying getting back to, how about we go, speaking of Blundo,
we were trying to figure out his record and call in Sammy Ford, the athletic director.
Listen, this is an easy thing to figure out.
Oh, okay, so you're saying I'm stupid.
So help me here, who is Blundo?
Blundo.
The great Blundo.
He is the head coach of...
sounds like a magician.
Well, listen, in a 5 or 6 year span...
Lassie, I'll explain it to you. I'll give you a little...
Lassie?
Okay.
Are your mics on? I don't see anything that would indicate...
The year prior to winning the state title, the team only lost 3 games. But we'll say 4 just to... make it. They played 30.
They played dirty.
So they either lost 3 games or they lost 4.
Well, I'm covering myself.
Oh, okay.
Then they won the state title and went undefeated.
31-0.
And the year prior to that.
If you lost 4 games.
The year prior to that, they lost 3.
Okay.
So they were like 90-7 at one point.
Okay.
Okay. Last year.
They were 22-6.
Okay, so that put them into the 120s with only 13 losses.
Actually,
and this year they're undefeated.
They're over 18-0 or something.
Yeah.
Like that.
90,
right,
okay, there's the Newcastle education for you. 90 plus 22 is 112, folks, not 120.
But I think his first year they were 20-8. I think
right. What I'm saying
but
is.
But I think they were 31-0, but before that they were 30-1.
You know what? I'm getting at 122-15. Well, that's where you're at right now.
Carry the 3.
122-15.
Is this common core math?
You said you're trying to figure out what his record is. I'm trying.
No.
Your hat usually had a cone on it there.
I'm going to start pouting.
You know.
No, wait a minute. But does he have over 200 victories in a short span, right?
Well, yeah. That's what it's coming close to because that's what I'm trying to explain.
All right. So,
but, in Ohio, where they don't have a WPIAL,
we don't need a bunch of alphabets. It's high school basketball.
Yeah, but you have different divisions. Yeah.
Who's the leader of the pack that's made for you and me? M-I-Z-K-E-Y.
What are you doing?
I'm going to Google it. Blundino.
Oh, no. Oh, that's a great idea. Look up Newcastle. Well, anyway, we're just saying they're doing such a great job. I know, again, last year they were 22-8. The year before they were 31-0. The year before that, to my knowledge, they were 30-1. They lost the state championship game. So we'll see. He may have close to 200 victories, but anyway, that's great for the community. It's great for the school, the administrators, the players, the parents. Just keep doing what you're doing because it's a great ride, and people. It's like back in the day with when Newcastle, with their football program. Okay? No? They used to have wrestling.
You like doing the show by yourself.
Yeah.
I'm just on my phone. He's
doing whatever. He's doing it. Well, at least Alexa's still here, even though you won't be able to hear her. But anyway, so yeah, I just think it's great. Sammy Floyd does a great job as an athletic director. He was a very good running back, too, back in, I think, 68, 69 or something like that.
Yep.
Back in the day. I don't know if he played on a 70 team that probably was one of the best teams in the country.
Blundino or Blandino?
No, his name is Blundo.
Blundo.
Uh-huh. Why don't you look for Newcastle Hurricane Basketball? Anyway, so, yeah, Sammy, so, doing a great job.
You know, we're going to have to tell him about this tomorrow.
Hold on, who? I got it.
Because
I'm on it.
He has it. It'll take him another 3 hours. But I hope everybody had a nice weekend. The snow has been unbelievable. We escaped.
Hooker equals school record in Newcastle. Oh, no.
No.
20-8.
No. Now they're going to figure it
out. Okay. 28-1. So that's 48.
Go ahead. Here we go. Go ahead.
48-9.
Okay. It's 57.
48-9 and 30-1. Is 78-10.
What?
78-10 and 31-0.
Where's
he at? 109.
His first season was
109-10.
Uh huh. Angela's got
109-10 and 23-6 is
109-10. It's 122 and 16.
Yep.
That's 122. Newcastle, Indiana.
122-16 and 16-0.
It's 132-16.
132-16.
So he hasn't. He's not close to winning.
What did I say? Rewind the tape again. I said 122
and 15. Yeah, you did.
Okay, now I'm saying time out. You lost. You didn't make it at the buzzer. Wave bye.
Time now.
See you tomorrow.
No way.
Bye.
Adios, muchacha.
Good night.
Huh? Good riddance.